In this movie, we're going to take a look at creating a lower third similar to this right inside of Adobe Premiere Pro using shapes as well as different types of fonts. Awesome. I'm just going to press the escape key to exit. And with my type tool selected, I'm going to click. That creates a new graphic clip just on top of it. I'm going to type in Eugene, followed by draw. I'm going to take this overall text, make it a lot bigger. Then I'm going to select the default selection tool and start to position this roughly where I want it in the frame. I want the second part of the text, or draw his last name, to actually be a semi-bold font, and the first part here in particular to be that of light. I'll then select the default selection tool, move it over. We can now start to create the additional elements that make up this text. One thing is the performer text, which is going to appear just above it, but we're going to use a different font for that. One way to set this up is I'm actually going to right-click this existing text and choose to duplicate it. I'll move this duplicate text just above it. And if I wanted to be precise, I could actually use the align and transform properties and just drag on the Y value. Let's double-click the entire text and type in performer, making sure that's also all in caps. I want this to be quite a bit smaller. I want to select the overall text and then bring it down, just noticing that it's happening from the lower left-hand side. If you're having trouble seeing this, keep in mind, go to your fit section of the window, which is fitting the video to this, and then just make it 75%, where you can then grab the hand tool and really focus in on how the text is aligning up here. A really handy tool is to select text, and then if you hold down the command or control key followed by the left and right arrows, you can nudge your text into place. This is looking pretty good, but this isn't the font that we want to use. From the text section, let's actually go to the drop-down arrow and add a font from Adobe Fonts. Clicking on the cloud icon right here, that will launch you to Adobe Fonts. I've got a few of those windows open up here. I'm actually just going to press OK to close them. And I'm going to type in S-I-G-N-O, which is Sino for the top family results. Currently, that's also available on Adobe Fonts. And notice that all different cases and weights of that font are currently saved to my system with this little blue icon right here. And that's all possible because I logged into Creative Cloud. Since I have that, I can easily select this from the text list. I'll head down to that section to find that font and make sure that a regular case is currently selected for it. That's looking great. Let's zoom out. We'll fit to the window. And we want to have a box that's going to be behind this performer text. So I'll do that by right-clicking and adding a new layer. It will be a rectangle layer. We'll make sure that that rectangle has a fill, no stroke. And with the actual default selection tool, I'll drag it and position it roughly to be the same size as our performer text. I'll then drag that shape, placing it underneath it, and get even clearer in terms of its size. You might want to go back and bring this back to 75% using that hand tool again. With the default selection tool, we can see the bounding box and how that shape is being formed around the performer text. I'm going to now zoom out from 75% to 50%. On my toolbar, select the pen tool. We're going to create a simple line shape just consisting of a stroke. So first of all, I'm going to click to add a point. That's going to create the new point, shape 02. I'll turn off the fill and add a red stroke. Using the hand tool temporarily, I'll just click and drag here over to the side, even though that first point has been created. Hop back to my pen tool now. And right around here, I'll try to create the first point. I'm just going to be very careful of how I create that point and also to make sure that it's as aligned and straight as possible to the first point that I created. I'll then click and drag, create another point right here. Click off and then try to straighten this. Use my hand tool temporarily just to sort of move back. Select the pen tool and then right around where the E ends and pretty much aligned with that third point I just created. I'll create that third point, click off for a second, and then drag it to make it as straight as possible. I'll then take a look at this overall shape with this fit to the window to see if that's roughly the same type of line that I had with the previous shape. With this tool still selected, just drag these points a little bit down, the third and fourth point created, just to add a bit more space there. Now I will go back to my default selection tool. I will drag out this specific text. Let me select the text. And what I'd like to animate together happens to be the Eugene Draw text, the first shape, the black square, and the performer text. I'll select all of them by clicking and shift-clicking, and then group them all as one object. I'll then rename shape number two, just call it line. I'll even rename shape number one, I'll call it rectangle. Now, the important thing with the group here that I have selected is its anchor point, and you'll see here it's at the center of the group. I'll take that and actually pivot it to the upper left-hand corner of my rectangle, because this is going to act as all the elements of this group to scale from. With the line itself, if I start to play around with the scale of the object, I can sort of see that the pivot point is at the middle of the object, which is fine. Since that's the first thing I want to animate, I'll move to the 1 second mark in my timeline. And under effect controls, let's take a look at the properties of that line. Where it says scale, I'm going to make sure the scale is not uniform, just to separate the vertical and horizontal scale. And let's add a keyframe for both horizontal and vertical. I'll move my playhead to the beginning of the timeline. Just even if I start to play with the vertical scale a little bit, you can sort of see one way that we can animate this object on. Creates a little interesting animation to the way that this grows. It's rather linear, but you can always select those keyframes, right or control click it, and then just choose to create a little bit more easing on that animation. To do that even further, I'll zoom in so we can see those keyframes, and under the vertical scale, select the last one and actually just play around with this graph, which will control how it eases in, making it even smoother there at the end. I'll actually move to the 15 frame mark, which is where I want to set up the remaining parts of this group. I want this to scale up in size. I'll close down the shape line one just to make this neater here. And under the group one's properties, I will click the stopwatch next to scale, add a value of 0. All those items in the group disappear. I'll now move to the 1 second and 15 frame mark here in my timeline or effect controls and scale this up to a value of 100. Before I preview this animation, I'll select each of those keyframes, right click and choose Bezier. I'll even twirl down those scale properties, select the keyframe and just kind of add more of an easing graph to add some nicer animation. You can see here, this could use some tweaking, but not too bad for our lower third setup. And in order to save this to the library, right-click and export this as a motion graphics template. That's how you can create a nice lower third inside of Adobe Premiere.